So for those of you who have not heard of us, we are an NSF-funded center here at Indiana University. We sit in the CIB building, the cyber infrastructure building on the bypass, the big glass building right next to IU Super, the data center that hosts our high-performance clusters. And what we do is we're a national center that allows the researchers, the genomics researchers around the country with their bioinformatic analysis. And sometimes it's as simple as just giving access to compute clusters or like giving them support with bioinformatics, like here's a workflow you could use or help them develop a workflow for them. We do training and workshops like this one and others. And we also have gateways, and I'll talk about what gateways are, but essentially websites where you can go ahead and run your bioinformatic analysis. And we have Galaxy, which Carrie knows a lot more about, Gene Pattern, which is for cancer researchers, and genome browsers if you're working on non-model organisms. You can actually set up your own genome browser. Okay, so meet the NCS team. We initially thought all of us would be here, but now there's a lot of things going on, so two of them are not here. This is Tom, who's our PI. He's the senior research scientist at the biology department as well. He does have a PhD in biology, so he knows a lot more fun facts in biology than all of us do. This is Carrie, who's right here. She was one of the earlier members of NCGAS. She's the guardian of the galaxy. We have two galaxies we support. One is only for IU folks, and the other one is national. And she supports both of them and makes sure all the software is on there. She loves turkeys, and she has a hobby farm. So if any of you have fun things to talk about, she really enjoys that. And she's a bioinformatics PhD student here. This is Sherry, who's not here today. She's also a bioinformatician. She has a PhD in biology. And she loves polyploidy and salamanders, and she's the one that supports genome browsers. Just letting you link to one of us today. This is me. I think microbes are cool, so if you have anything microbial, I will help you. I love them. And I'm also a bioinformatics PhD student. So the reason I'm putting this slide here is to let you all know that all of us do have a biology background, and we all somehow move towards bioinformatics and are working towards bioinformatics. So if you are scared to talk to a computer scientist, don't be, because we all came from that background, and no question is you know, just too basic. Everything is actually valid, and we've all asked those questions before, so please feel free to ask them. We do have a collaborator. We work, NCGAS has a collaborator with Pittsburgh National Supercomputing Center, which has tons more data, and I'll talk to you a little more about all that. And this is Phil, who is the computational biologist, who helps us with a lot of stuff. So this is essentially the NCGAS team. We're just a four-member team with Phil at BSC. Apart from that, you know, we have the research technologies team that is supporting this workshop right now through UITS. So we work with all of them. Who do we serve? We're paid to serve NSF-funded researchers, but that's necessarily not the case. We have helped USDA and NIH grants. Sometimes we're written into grants for pay work, but we'll also help otherwise. It's not only pay, we do help otherwise as well. And we're right here at Indiana University, so if you guys need help, we're right here. We can come meet you as well and set up meetings. We have successfully, I think, we have users in all states across the country. This is just to show you that we're not making any of this data up. We are valid. We've been, NCGAS started in 2011, so we've been here for a really long time. And we're currently on our third NSF sustaining grant. This is some of the projects that we've helped with. Just to point out that we do work with a lot of non-model organisms. That is somehow most of our interest as well between the four of us. And so if you're working on a non-model organism and are worried that you won't get enough attention, don't worry. We all love them. So if you're interested, get an NCGAS affiliate or allocation account that just lets us know what your project is, and we're more aware of when you're asking for help, we sort of know where you're coming from. About computational resources, as Indiana University students, faculty, or staff, you do have access to all the IU resources here. Ask us questions, email us at help@ncgas.org anytime, and we will reply back. And it can be something as simple as, I'm getting started, I don't know where to start, and we'll help you with that. We do have XSEED and JetStream, which is national clusters available, and I'll talk to you a little more on that. And if you do want more attention from us, you can put us into your grants. Not a necessity, but if you want more attention, that's possible.